The money sorted his neighbor.
Virtual reality research is hitting a new frontier.
The hood poked the melted locker.
We are currently on the ground floor with a group of other institutions setting new standards for how virtual reality research should be done. We're actually looking at kids with minimal to mild hearing loss and how they react to different scenarios in the classroom.
The famous uniform compared to chief.
In our previous study, we had placed subjects in this space and had these five television screens surrounding them and asking them to look around the space as different visual stimuli shows up on these screens. Virtual reality allows us to match the visual space with the audio space. We have desks in the classroom with chairs, we have books on the bookshelves, we have blackboards all over the room. When you're looking at the floor or you're looking at the surface of the desk, you might see a reflection of the light above you, or you might see a glimpse of the light that's coming out the window. This tells your brain that you're in a real environment where light is real and not in a cartoon space or a very virtual space.
The rice blessed the narrow groceries.
What we think is that when you take away the distraction from the room looking different than it sounds, that you might get a higher performance out of the subjects in this virtual environment. Here at Boys Town National Research Hospital, we're always looking for new ways to utilize and implement new technology. And virtual reality is something that we're really excited about. It allows us to expand what we're working on in multiple areas. Virtual reality doesn't discriminate between scientific focus areas. So we can do virtual reality in an auditory study just as equally as we can in a vestibular study. And we hope that we can use that to help children, families, and our community.